Have you ever wondered how you can make passive income online?
Well, in this video, we interview a very dear friend and client and inspiration to our YouTube channel, Miss Marissa Romero.
So welcome to Medellin, Colombia. Let's go ahead and head over to the interview.
So let's just jump right into it. Marissa, could you please introduce yourself?
Sure. Hey everyone, my name is Marissa and I'm an online entrepreneur and my specialty is YouTube marketing. I do have a channel and at the moment it's closing in on 50,000 subscribers. A little bit about my journey. I've actually been a digital nomad now for about 18 months, maybe a little bit longer than that.
Mm-hmm. I'm so glad you said digital nomad. Can you explain to our audience what a digital nomad is in the first place?
I can do that. So my definition of a digital nomad is somebody who is able to work completely remote from wherever they want in the world, as long as they have a computer, a laptop, or an internet connection. Mm-hmm.
So being a digital nomad, it is very important that you do create passive income streams in order to do that.
Yeah.
And you've been able to do that successfully for the past 18 months. So tell me about some of the other income streams that you've created throughout your journey.
Sure. My journey is a little bit interesting. Before the YouTube channel, I was doing e-commerce, and that was actually a lot of active work. With the YouTube channel came an opportunity to not only create passive income, but to create leads overnight to my business, to create an audience of people that are hungry buyers that want to buy like the services and products that I have to offer. So when it comes down to the income streams that I've created for myself, there's definitely some income streams that are more active and some that are more passive. And so people think, when they think of YouTube, people think of it more as a social media platform. But when you think of YouTube as strictly a source of traffic, everything changes or could change for your online business. And so when I realized that, I'm like, you know what? This is the platform that I really want to go hard and build my traffic source, because it grows for you. As long as you're consistent on the platform, it'll keep bringing you leads, sales, 24/7 while you sleep. But the other thing it gives you, it provides you the opportunity for so many more things, like brand deals, collaborations. I still do one-on-one coaching. I do group coaching. And so there's so many opportunities that come with having a YouTube channel.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, I know one thing when we talk about YouTube and passive income, I think it's fair that we just define passive income to make sure we're on the same page. What we typically say passive income is income that works while you're sleeping. Now, the misconception of passive income is that people think that you don't have to do anything to obtain passive income. But I think that we'd like to say that with passive income, there is either an initial investment for maybe a business or something that's cash flowing, or an initial investment of time. So with YouTube, we can totally second that you definitely have to grind, get your videos out there and get out in front of people. But the minute you've launched a video, it is continuing to be shown with an audience all around the world.
So I think one of the common misconceptions about passive income is that there is a lot of upfront work that you have to do in order to be successful with it.
Oh, yeah.
So I think that steers some people away from it because it's such an easy thing just to, you know, go to work for a few hours and get guaranteed a check every single week.
Guaranteed, yeah.
With passive income, that's not necessarily the case unless you put in that upfront work.
Mm-hmm, absolutely. So Marissa, you had mentioned several streams of income that she's creating online just through a YouTube channel. So to reiterate them in case you missed it, she is cash flowing just from having a YouTube channel through the ads that are put on her channel. She has an online course. She does coaching. Did I miss anything else?
Affiliate marketing
still. That's just four streams of income that we're talking about just straight from her channel. This is mind-blowing, ladies and gentlemen. So which one of those streams of income is your favorite and why?
Well, I love them all, but if I had to pick one, I would definitely say affiliate marketing is my favorite. That was my main business model that I focused on my first year with my channel, was building up those recurring affiliate commissions. And so affiliate marketing is when you promote a product that isn't yours and you just connect the buyer to the product. And when you sell a product that's not yours, the company gives you a commission anywhere between 20% and sometimes even 100% depending on the product. And so I tell people affiliate marketing is the the best way to kind of get your, you know, toe in the water when you're building your online business, because it's not your product, you don't have to pay for marketing, you don't have to fulfill the product. But also it's really cool because you can develop this thing called recurring commissions. So let's say you're promoting an online business software like ClickFunnels or maybe an email marketing platform that all business owners need. Mm-hmm. And you're getting, let's say the plan costs $100 and somebody signs up with your link and you get 30%. That's $30 predictably in your pocket for a very long time. And so as long as that person continues to use the tool, you will continue to get paid every single month. And I love the recurring commissions because even though they're a lot smaller, they're super predictable. And you, if you build it up, that's predictable income every single month. And especially if you're using the tool yourself, it's great because you can teach it and tell people how to do it. And you, that increases your income more, you know, on a YouTube channel or even another social media platform. So I would say if I had to choose, affiliate marketing is definitely great because you have the recurring piece of it, but you could also promote services of other people. Like you can promote high ticket products, you can promote events, you can promote merchandise. The list is just endless with how you can make affiliate marketing income.
Yeah, with affiliate marketing, I would say this is something that we talked about that requires time. There is no upfront investment when it comes from a monetary standpoint. It's all about your time. So in this case, affiliate marketing is huge because just think about it. Let's like simplify it for a moment. How many times have you recommended a doctor or a service or a product to somebody and they bought that or they made the appointment with the doctor? This is the same thing with affiliate marketing. We're just recommending products and services and getting a commission from it. So this is one thing that we definitely know from our experience is an amazing way to create passive income.
Mm-hmm. And even just simple things around the house, like do you recommend a blender? Do you recommend a coffee pot? If you do, or if you recommend a camera, like the camera we're using to film this video, there is an easy way to get an affiliate link for it on Amazon.com. Who doesn't use Amazon.com, right?
Everyone in the United States uses Amazon quite frequently.
Yeah. Yeah.
Quite frequently.
We're even trying to figure out a way to get stuff shipped to us in the DR. So yeah, we're trying to max out Amazon as much as possible.
So Marissa, tell us, how important do you think passive income is for your business and your lifestyle since you travel all over the world?
Yeah, definitely. That's a great question. I think it's really important to have at least, well, one, but especially two or three sources of passive income coming that are predictable, because let's say your main moneymaker is coaching or maybe one-on-one consulting, right? If you don't have any clients or your clientele goes down, you still have something coming into your bank every single month. So I think really it's security really is what you're building for yourself. And so what I love about it is I'm like, okay, well maybe if my one-on-one clients go down, I know that I have my Google AdSense, I have my commissions from this product, and this product. I'm like, yeah, I will be able to. It's great to know that you can definitely more than survive. How do you say that? Like, you're comfortably good if my coaching were to go down and my one-on-one clients were to go down.
Yeah, and I think that's important in being able to think clearly, because by having some monetary issue with money that's coming in or money that's not coming in, that really holds you back from being the best version of yourself. Ooh. And that's super important to generate the lifestyle that you want. Mm-hmm. So kudos.
Yeah,
kudos.
Yeah. What I was going to say to piggyback off of that, one thing that we didn't touch on is Marissa came from the engineering world. We all came from corporate America, so we are all used to getting that one stream of income and praying to God that that thing holds on. So now having passive income, how has that completely just changed your lifestyle?
I put it like this. It's great because, and I don't mean this in a boastful way, but I don't have to worry anymore about how much something costs on the menu. Like I can eat freely whenever I want, whatever I want on the menu. And it's just stuff like that. Like I never have to worry about the cost of rent.
Snaps.
You know, I don't have to worry about how I'll pay my bills every single month. It's just, it's so great. Yeah, it's just, it really does give you that ease of mind as an entrepreneur, because entrepreneurship is so hard as it is. Mm-hmm. And for you to be have that worry about your income all the time and just how to serve. If you don't have those, if I didn't have these passive income streams, it would be another job, really. It would be just like having my job when I was working for the government as an engineer.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Thank you for that. It is very powerful when you realize that the money just keeps coming. And like you said, you don't have to worry about a lot of the things that you typically had to worry about if you just only survived on one stream of income. So when we talk about passive income, this whole video today is really just to enlighten the audience and to let you guys know that it is possible. We all came from corporate America, but yet we're all sitting here in Medellin, Colombia, collecting passive income. And we just want to be able to provide value to you all today and share this information so that you can either create that initial investment to get you to passive income or that investment of time.
Right, so make sure you comment below if you are a digital nomad or you have passive income that you're generating online. Mm-hmm. Please let us know in the comment section. And make sure you subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell to be notified when we post our next video.
All right, Marissa, so the next question that we want to ask you is, how do you think earning money online is impacting our society?
I really think it's been a beautiful transformation, honestly. I don't know how else to say it, because I heard this once from an eight-figure earner, online business owner, that like if I were to have a gun to my head and I had to create a bunch of cash tomorrow, what would you do? What would I do? I would sell my knowledge, right? And it's crazy because there's every single person, I think, on earth has something that they can create online and has something that they could sell passively. Right, especially in the form of digital courses, because you know we both have digital courses, and I only create it once. I teach people one time, and it sells. Well, I don't have to sell it. The traffic is going to my sales funnel. It's working for me. I'm leveraging that income 24/7, and I think that when you create passive income, and when a family or somebody, even if you still have a job, like this is very easy, not easy, but it's very simple to do the framework to build at least one stream of passive income for yourself. So that way, as a business owner and even somebody who still has a 9-to-5, you could be more of the visionary. Mm-hmm. More of the visionary for your business and just have that peace of mind, like for your family, that you have something reliable coming in every single month. Also, it opens up a new realm of people being able to interact worldwide, globally. Like I said, we're here in Medellin, Colombia. We met in Phoenix, Arizona. We'll probably travel next year to Europe and who knows where else. But it's really great because with other entrepreneurs in this city, they've created their income streams online, and we've been able to meet here and create a community here, and it's so cool. Not only that, there is no limit to who you can impact and who the people you can teach. I mean, I have students all the way in across the world in New Zealand. That's still crazy to me. Like, I wake up, I'm like, how is that even real? So it's the expansion that the passive income really allows, you know, people to have.
Yeah, I mean, just it's so powerful. I remember when Marissa actually sold her course and she had the student abroad, and we were like, this is amazing. It was so exciting because, again, it's just a constant reminder of how powerful online businesses are. And in fact, being here in Medellin, we met our videographer. He's from Costa Rica. Shout out to Christian. His link will be below. But anyways, it's just amazing to meet people from all over the world who are making moves online and who are connecting with people all over the world.
And the other thing too is being able to influence different cultures.
Yeah.
Because for example, in South America, in Latin America as a whole, the concept of just the internet and being able to have an income on the internet is so foreign to them.
Yes.
And when, you know, they see us do it and see that it's possible, it just sparks them, it gives them ideas. Mm-hmm. And for them to get out of that paradigm where I need to have active income and work my whole entire life to make a salary.
So if you're subscribed to our channel, you're very familiar with what we talk about. We talk about the concept of infinite banking and leveraging whole life insurance cash value to borrow from your policies in the place of a bank. And by doing this, you pay yourself the interest that would have otherwise gone to a bank. So Marissa, tell us, why was infinite banking attractive to you?
Well, infinite banking was attractive because in order to build my business, I in the beginning, I took out a lot of money, and I did that through credit cards. You know, I opened up a bunch of streams of credit, and it's really, I had a big dip in my entrepreneurship journey. Like I was, and when I switched from the e-commerce land to, you know, YouTube, I was in such extreme debt, and I was getting crushed even more with having to pay back interest rates. You know, it was like every payment was nothing. It wasn't getting the balance down at all. And it just seemed like I was just a hamster on the running wheel. I couldn't make a dent into it. And it was really frustrating. But then when I asked them, I'm like, so what is it exactly you guys do? I don't really understand. But I know they were able to pay off their debt. And I'm like, how? And so I want to pay off my debt. And so they introduced me to the infinite banking concept, where you can create your own banking system, you know, through, you know, whole life insurance. And it's great because you are now switching it up and paying yourself back the money and paying yourself back the interest instead of to a bank with leveraging a policy. And so I'm still tired of giving some of that money to the banks, but eventually I don't want to give any money to the banks. And I'm like, yeah, I really want to start them, you know, get a policy and start infinite banking. Yeah. Simple. It's what I had done every single month for years before. It's the same thing. I don't have to do anything. It's just you pay yourself first, you know, and you can easily do that with any online banking, with any bank. I mean, you just set it up automatically, you know, instead of paying that $50 interest to a credit card you pay that to your savings account or a segregated account where you don't even touch it. And so you're building up that account, which keeps growing every single month, so that, you know, you're getting that income stream.
Another income stream, absolutely. All right, so to tie it all together, we talk about infinite banking and we marry it with passive income. The importance of creating passive income is so that you can fuel your banking system. That allows your banking system to grow even more aggressively and gives you access to more cash value so you can pay off more debt, invest in more businesses, create a YouTube channel, whatever it is that you want to do. So the importance of sharing this information with you all today is we have a slew of people that are always talking about the importance of hard assets. And in this video, we haven't talked at all about hard assets. And when I say hard assets, I mean real estate or precious metals, for example. But Marissa has created four streams of income online, specifically just using digital assets. And she's cash flowing just as much, if not more, than investors who are relying on real estate or the stock market or precious metals or whatever the case may be. So we just wanted to switch things up a little bit in this video and teach you about the world of online marketing, of being a digital nomad, and really owning your own lifestyle so that you can create your own forms of passive income and travel the world or do whatever it is that you are passionate about.
So Marissa, for someone who's new to the idea of generating passive income online, how would you say they initially get started?
With YouTube, of course. really, there's gonna be two things that are involved with passive income. It's the way we do it with digital courses, affiliate marketing. I say step one is to choose your traffic source, because you're gonna need a source of traffic to go to whatever offer or services you're marketing, right? And so I tell people, you know, YouTube is number one, hands down, the most powerful, because it's something, as opposed to Facebook, where you have to pay to get something seen, or Instagram, where it's only popular and getting traffic for the first 2 hours after you post something. You know, YouTube will work for you and it will grow for you. The algorithm wants to show your videos and your content to people. And so I would say pick a platform that you want to dominate, a social media platform. And from there, figure out what you like. Like, what is your passion, or what really is your expertise? What can you happily teach people? What can you teach people for free? What do people say that you're good at? What do people ask you about all the time and ask for advice? So think about these questions, and then think about the thing that you can say, yeah, people, the one trend that you find Is it profitable? Like, is there a demand for it? Are other people selling products relating to it? Are there affiliate products within that niche that you could sell and promote on your YouTube channel in the description or on Instagram or Facebook, whatever platform you choose? So I would say that's definitely step one.
So Marissa, one thing that I picked out of what you just said was one thing that we haven't even talked about, which is organic traffic. You had mentioned Facebook and other streams of traffic. We aren't even talking about paying for advertising, which is something that I want to make sure that we clarify. We're talking about the world of organic traffic, meaning that people are organically coming to you because they're searching for the information that you provide. Exactly, and they want to. So think of, you know, you guys here on YouTube. What do you type in typically on YouTube and look at all of the information that comes up? These individuals, these content creators aren't paying to be able to put their information on YouTube. And then another thing I wanted to ask you is a lot of people tell us all the time, oh, somebody's already talking about what I'm talking about on YouTube, or there's millions of people talking about what I'm talking about on YouTube. How relevant is that statement?
It's very relevant. However, there's never too much competition. Never, something is never too saturated. There's always room for you to succeed on any platform, but especially on YouTube. YouTube, I think in my lifetime, in our lifetime, isn't going anywhere, right? And there's always room for creators, for business owners to use YouTube as a business. Just think about, was it 90% of internet users or something you told me? Use YouTube every day,
yeah,
right?
Every single day.
Yeah, and so people are actively looking to solve the problems that they have in their life, and they can find you on YouTube. And once they see your content and you become the reliable resource and the trusted resource for whatever it is they're looking for, and that's why they come back and your content gets watched, they binge watch your content, they start to trust you more, and then eventually they will buy from you. So there's never too many, you know, channels about fitness. There's never too many channels about cooking. Whatever it is, you can start a channel.
So Marissa, this is information that you share directly on your channel, correct?
Correct.
So what's the name of your channel so we can connect with you?
Yeah, so the name of my channel is my name, Marissa Romero, with one R and two S's. They could link it up here and they'll add it in the description as well. If you guys are seriously interested in building a business with YouTube and growing your business and your brand online, I do have a blueprint that you can download. They'll have it in their description. It's called the Subscribers to Sales Blueprint, where I go over 6 steps on basically how to take your channel from complete zero to 10K subscribers to 6 figures on YouTube. It's exactly what I teach my own students. So I definitely encourage you to download that blueprint.
Absolutely, we can speak from complete experience. Marissa has taught us everything that we know as far as YouTube is concerned, and she is the reason, like I said earlier, why we have a channel in the first place. Well, Marissa, thank you so much for your time today. It has been a complete pleasure. Thank you for the interview and allowing us to crash with you in Medellin, Colombia for this past month. It's been absolutely amazing. So thank you all for watching, and don't forget to own your own lifestyle.
Or someone else will.